Well, Gene, we can give you a live look at the damage right now. These two trailers that you see here actually got it the best. The one that got it the worst is completely reduced. And there just isn't anything out here that those investigators think could have caused this fire accidentally. The trailers didn't have any fuel or accelerants inside. There are high-tension power lines overhead, but those have already been ruled out, although they did make for an interesting firefight.
Firefighters tried to keep the spray to a minimum as they knocked down flames burning in three storage trailers at the Londonderry flea market Tuesday night. High-voltage power lines overhead forced them to be cautious.
We have to be careful not to create a stream that'll conduct the electricity.
The fire started just before 7 o'clock, and the huge column of smoke rising from the trailers quickly drew the attention of neighbors.
It was really thick, yeah, really, really thick. It was like, it was, you couldn't even see the sky. Like, yeah, it was bad.
The flames consumed shelving, spare machine parts, signs, and other maintenance odds and ends, reducing one trailer to its frame and melting the aluminum siding off another. But when crews arrived, the fire was under control within minutes.
When the Londonderry truck got here, I mean, they put the one tanker and it took it right down almost immediately.
The trailers are set back from the actual flea market property and will not impact business this weekend. Owner Pete Zapatis says the losses are negligible.
I hate losing it, but what I lost, I'm not sure of.
Zapatis is worried the fire was started on purpose.
It had to be youngsters. They hang out back here all the time.
Firefighters say the cause is under investigation. Police officers examining the trailers referred to the charred rubble as a crime scene.
We're assuming it's suspicious due to the location.
Fire officials are happy to report no one was hurt in the firefight. Again, the owner here says that things should proceed normally this weekend. There's 9 weeks left in the season, and there is not anticipated to be any impact to business. Reporting live in Londonderry, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.